So Tina, do you think belonging to a subculture clan is a fashion statement for one of the individuality?
I think it's probably a fashion statement since people might want to join in a group not only because of their own interests, but they might be isolated with the others. So they want to join in a group in order to their friends, and they might also want to change their lifestyle, so they join in a subculture.
And I also agree because my cousin, who's also an engineer, he also spends his free time by doing like what he wants. Like he really likes rock music, so he's also part of the band that plays rock music. So and next question, how does belonging to a certain subculture, a certain clique, affect the person's language? What do you think?
I think people who are in a certain clique may use the terms that are only used for this subculture. I think the relationship is very close.
Oh yeah, I also can think of an example. For example, hip-hop subculture. And most people who belong to that subculture is originated from Africa. So maybe their accent or terms they use might somehow be related to their origin. And what about the relationship between culture and
relationship? I think language is a huge part of the culture, and it's also a way to it's a way to spread the culture.
I also think like there are these two areas. I don't know how to say it, but these two parts are like interrelated, and without language, there won't be culture, and without culture, there also won't be language. Thank you.